Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Microbes in Human Welfare. In that, today we'll be studying about bioactive molecules. When I say bioactive molecules, it means molecules or acids or enzymes which help humans in day-to-day life. For example, gibberellins, cyclosporin, all this have wide application in human as well as plant life. Today we'll be studying about chapter Microbes in Human Welfare. In that, we'll be studying about biomolecules or bioactive molecules. When I say about bioactive molecules, bio means biology and active means molecules whose activity help mankind or human being. One of the easiest or simplest examples of bioactive molecules are gibberellins. Second one would be cyclosporin A. Now cyclosporin A is a bioactive molecule that is given to patients who have undergone organ transplant. When I say organ transplant, it means a particular organ is removed and an organ which did not belong to them is added to them. Now this immunosuppressant agent cyclosporin A suppress their immune system, it means slow their immune system so that organ or the kidney or any other part can be accepted by them. This foreign organ belongs to somebody else, so this will be rejected by their immune system. Second bioactive molecule is statins. Statins are blood cholesterol lowering agents. They help to lower the blood cholesterol in myocardial patients. The third agent is gibberellins. Gibberellins is growth hormones which helps in active growth of the plant. It also helps in parthenocarpy of fruits, that is formation of fruits without seeds. So let us say all the bioactive molecules. Let us study how they are made and what is their function. Let us see what bioactive molecules are. One example of bioactive molecule is cyclosporin. It is an immunosuppressive agent given to organ transplant patients. Basically, cyclosporins are given to patients who have undergone kidney transplant so as to suppress or slow down their immune system. The next agent is statins. They are produced by fungus given for lowering blood cholesterol. Basically, statins are given to myocardial patients or patients who have higher level of cholesterol or bad fats. The third bioactive agent is gibberellins. Gibberellin is basically a plant hormone. They are group of growth promoting antibiotics, which are. Now let us see the third bioactive molecule, which is gibberellins. These are nothing but plant growth hormones. Gibberellins, they are group of growth promoting hormones which are used in stem elongation. They are naturally present in plants that help in stem elongation. Even they are available commercially. They are used in elongation of roots also. So basically, gibberellins help in shoot as well as root elongation. They are induce parthenocarpy. Okay, when we use gibberellins, they help us to induce parthenocarpy in fruits. When I say parthenocarpy, it means fruits without seed. Basically, gibberellins which help in production of fruit without seed in case of fruits like pear and banana. Parthenocarpic fruits are widely used. They are fruits without seed and are widely accepted, which are produced with the help of gibberellins. So in this part of the chapter, we studied about bioactive molecules, their function, then their uses. Thank you.